Hey guys, so Monday night we held the finals for our Madden tournament. I am happy to bring that footage to you on our channel.
And the second quarter is underway with this snap. And they are in on Peterson. The Vikings have it at the 29. And it's knocked down. Now inside the 30 at the 29. Third and 7. And incomplete. He was looking for Rudolph.
Quarterbacks love to see a receiver have this type of play. Even though he doesn't make the catch, the effort is outstanding, and he's given everything he has to make that catch.
An empty possession for the offense. Interesting little chess match game here as they miss the long field goal and set up the opponents now with an excellent starting point.
Anytime you talk about a long field goal, it's 50-50 at best. That time, the mechanics of the situation were not perfect. Doesn't look like a good hold, and that's why they missed.
Murray's brought down after picking up only a yard.
Murray's a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short game.
When the Raiders beat the Vikings back in Super Bowl 11, Fred Biletnikoff was the game's MVP. And you know, Phil, I can still see Coach Madden riding off the field on the shoulders of his players.
Yeah, you know, Jim, so can I. It was a great moment for that organization. So many good years the Raiders had under John Madden. But how about that game? Fred Biletnikoff was outstanding, and like you said, was the MVP.
Second down following the run.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
Griffin's there to make the tackle.
Well, we just don't talk about it enough. He is so good, has such quick feet, and then when he gets outside, if you make him run, he will. And a good job there picking up some extra yards.
The Vikings come out in a dime package. The Raiders from the 37. Carr's unable to connect that time.
Man, the quarterback, the coaches, his teammates, everybody loves to see a player give that type of effort. How about the receiver just going all out to make the catch? Doesn't quite get there, but the effort is outstanding.
You ready? Hold on, baby. Alert! Alert!
The Raiders from the 37. Murray's handed the football. Space to work. No doubt about it. Touchdown.
How about the blocking up front? Lets the running back get in the secondary, and he is so quick and elusive. He avoids the tackles and takes it all the way for the touchdown.
The Vikings will now be in an even deeper hole here as they get ready to return the kick. Scores 21-0. Patterson will test the coverage. He had nowhere to go, and they deck him at the 16-yard line. The Vikings. Phil, what's the issue with this team? This offense specifically. Three straight drives without a score.
Well, Jim, I'd say this. It's bad coaching. I just hate what they're trying to do on the offensive side. They're not putting their players in position to give them a chance to compete against this defense. They've got to change things up, give their offense a chance, and give these players a chance.
Second down and 9. Rudolph's got it on a pass that had some heat. And he's going to be tackled right around the 37. That's another reception given to. Looks like they're in press coverage here. Peterson. And that's good for only a yard or two.
The defensive line's all shifting to the right. They're going to try to find a way to pressure the quarterback.
Second and 8. And he's forced to the ground. Now looking at third down.
That incompletion by the quarterback, hey, I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player. He's in position and able to make the football be incomplete.
Set up return. Here he goes.
Raiders know there's three parts to every football game: offense, defense, and special teams. What a play for the special teams here. Good punt return, good blocking, they get it done.
The Vikings defense comes onto the field after surrendering a touchdown on the last drive.
Well, they're hoping for better results, no question about that, Jim. They got to come out, they got to hustle. There was not enough hustle last time, and the number one key for all defensive teams is play hard.
Way to call them out there, partner.
Hey, that's what I do. I like to call people. Murray's never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, well, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
The Vikings lined up in the nickel. Second down and six. Streeter with the grab.
That time the quarterback throws the drag route. It doesn't get a first down, but still it's a good decision by him. The throw was right on target, and it picked up solid yards. Look what the defensive line is doing. They're all pinching down inside. They're expecting a run.
The Raiders believe they can pick up the first in this short yardage situation and keep the offense on the field.
The quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
The Raiders turn the ball over on downs. And we've reached the two-minute warning. Welcome back. Halftime just a couple of minutes away as we resume play out of the two-minute warning. Bridgewater standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Woodson with the interception.
Good job that time by the defense. Not being fooled. Being in position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play. That time they did, they got the interception.
The Raiders found themselves in good position the last time they had the ball, but chose to go for it on fourth down instead of bringing out the field goal unit. And that proved to be costly.
Yeah, they got to remember who they're going against on the defensive side. This defensive coordinator is smart. He knows all these situations, and he guessed right with the offensive coordinator.
Boy, for as well as they drove the ball down the field the last time they had it, only to come up empty on that fourth down stop. How is this offense going to react on this drive?
I don't know. I can tell you from experience, it's demoralizing when you drive the football and you get in scoring territory where it's 3 or 7 and you come away with nothing. It's tough. So you got to pick yourself up and make it happen.
Third down on the way. The Raiders come to the line. First down marker at the 40. They'll send it back to the quarterback out of the gun. Looking at every option. Carr's taking off. Catches the ball on the sideline, but does not get both feet down.
The Raiders really don't have much of a chance of picking up this first down. It's third and long. Of course, the defense is looking for passes down the field. They're all over everything, and the pass goes incomplete.
Patterson's going to take this one from the 18 and a run back of about 11. The Raiders defense, Phil, has been the story of this game.
Yeah, so few words. That's not like you. Usually it takes more words than that to describe what's going on, but you're right. They've been dominating physically, just getting it done, and if they keep this up, there's no way the other team's going to win.
He's got the catch, and they are in on Peterson. They hurry to the line of scrimmage. The Vikings will take the snap from the 35. Pass is intercepted. Heading into the half, and the defense continues to dominate the opposition.
Well, they are playing smothering defense. That's what they're doing. They're just Every play that we see the offense run, the defense is right there making a tackle, getting turnovers. Hey, man, this has been fun to watch.
Launches it down the field. And they can't connect.
Got to give this secondary credit. In this passing league now, it's hard to make plays, but a good play there and another incomplete pass.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one.
And a flag comes out. And this goes incomplete as he was looking over the middle.
Holding. Defense. Automatic first down.
The line of scrimmage, the 43-yard line.
The quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing the play here.
Got a big lane. Carr's able to get the job done and picks up the first down.
One more snap, and we'll head to halftime.
And that's going to do it for the first half, folks. We'll be back to Raiderland for the start of the second half after this. Here at the O.co Coliseum. Third quarter about to get underway. Jim Nansen, Phil Sims from the broadcast booth above the 50. That was a good kick return, and now the offense will try to take advantage. The Raiders offense takes the field. Let's see if this momentum can carry over from the first half, because they have been brilliant to this point, Parker.
Yeah, a lot of things change in that locker room at halftime. You know, you might feel good about what you've done. Of course, you got to realize the defense might be upset and is willing to come out here and take more chances in the second half.
No time to huddle now.
First and 10. Murray's got it on the handle. The Raiders get a first down. He's now over 60 yards rushing on the ground. First down at the 40. Carr's now going to leave the pocket and tuck it under.
Carr's athletic enough to get out of the pocket. That's a really good job by him. But you have to give the defense a lot of credit. They shut down all the receivers.
The line of scrimmage is at the 40. The Vikings defense now is going to go nickel.
Look out. They're changing the play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side.
And he's taken down, but not until he picks up the first. Wasting little time. Now first and 10. Airing it out. It's intercepted. The Vikings trail right now with all of these turnovers. Bridgewater has been a part of the problem today here, Phil.
I have to agree with you, Jim. He is the biggest problem of all. When the quarterback is not executing at a high level, it's hard for the football team to overcome that.
Phil, how about this defense with the interception perhaps being the difference maker for the offense to finally wake up and play?
Well, the offense has got to go out there, relax, and don't press. When you try hard or too hard and stress on the offensive side, it never works out for you.
Second down, tough field position here.
Time for the hurry up offense.
Second down and 8. Peterson's taking the handoff. A gain of about 5. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
When you're on the defensive side in a situation like this, you know the offense is going to be limited. Be aggressive. Get up there at the line of scrimmage and try to make it happen. That time they did it, and they stopped the run for just a short gain.
We'll go no huddle. First down and 10. We'll go ground.
Jackson. McGill's gonna make the tackle. First down here. Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. Adrian Peterson takes the football. He'll pick up 7 this time. Second down and 2 to go after the running play. They're going to the hurry. Back to the line now.
Now he's gonna change the play. Look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
He's got some daylight. A foot race to the end zone. In stride, and he's home for the touchdown.
Nowadays, so many kids, they grow up, they want to be wide receivers. I don't blame them. They're out there, they get to catch the football, they get to score touchdowns, they get to do dances, and you're not really allowed to hit them either. What a job.
And Wallace taking a breather as the kicking team comes out. He just contributed over 60 yards receiving on that scoring drive. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. Everson Griffin readying himself for this next possession. And it's been a long day for this unit, and any hopes they had of turning things around at halftime haven't come to fruition.
Yeah, listen, I don't know what they did at halftime, but whatever they did, it didn't work. They just got to pick up the pace. You got to have some pride on the defensive side. That's what they need right now. Murray's trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
Second and 9 coming up. Trying to beat the play clock. Murray's going to take the handoff now. Rose is there to make the tackle.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Third and 2 here after the run. Play clock's running down. Reese is going to secure the handoff.
Good job by the offense picking up a first down there. They've been terrific all day long. They're winning the football game, and they are tiring this defense out.
They're able to move the chains after that last run. A little jumpy there by that defensive front.
Encroachment defense. First
down. The Raiders from the 37. They feed it to him one more time.
What a good job by the running back that time. He reads the blocks very well, and he picks his way through there and picks up a first down. That's nice.
They better hurry to get the snap. They'll stay on the ground on first down. Murray's tackled down after a gain of 2.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Grabbing the face mask. We see it almost once a week, and here it happens again.
Well, a lot of times these defenders, I'll give them a little slack because they're running so fast, they're trying to tackle some tremendous athletes in open space, and sometimes accidentally you're going to grab the face mask.
Murray's handing the football. That's a gain of 6. The Raiders are still in possession as we get this final quarter underway. The line of scrimmage is the 33. The Vikings with a nickel look here on defense. Murray's got on the handle.
happening. Offense.
The defense accepts the penalty. Here they come to the 41-yard line. For this play, they'll go with two tight ends. Second and 12. Smith makes the catch.
When you have a lead in the fourth quarter, you like these short completions because you pick up yards and that clock keeps moving.
This is third down.
Look at the signals. The D-line is all shifting down inside. They're expecting a run right up the middle.
Running room. Carnes going to slide and avoid the hit.
Good job that time by the quarterback sliding. The team, you are valuable to them throwing the football, not running. Slide before you take that hit. Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
Helus tackled down after a gain of 5.
The Raiders, they can do it all. Once they get in the red zone, they have the passes, the screens. They can throw it down to back in the end zone. And how about that play? They can run the football right at you if they want to. And that time, they picked up some good yards on that run.
They need to get the playoff.
Murray's got it. Screen play. 6 for the Raiders. That's his second touchdown today. That touchdown, Phil, halfway through the fourth quarter, may have been the one that locked it up.
Jim, it's been a wonderful day by the offense, and on the other side, the defense. Oh, my gosh, I don't know what to say except that they were just terrible. They never had any answers. They didn't change their strategy. So the coaches, they got to be disappointed in their decisions, and the players, their effort was just awful.
Patterson's tackled down at the 17. That return's good for about 22. The Raiders' secondary could not stop the pass on the last series.
Well, they were just too timid. They were giving up too much room, making some of the throws too easy for the quarterback. Man, you got to man up, get up there tight, and cover these guys closely.
And they are in on Peterson.
Look at that. Everybody at the line of scrimmage. The defense showing a blitz.
Second and 2. Launching it deep. And it falls incomplete.
Well, the quarterback that time tried to squeeze it into tight coverage, but no can do. The coverage is too good. The football falls incomplete.
Third and 2. He's drilled as he throws.
Vikings will second guess that play call. That time on third short, they throw the football. Everybody thought they were going to run it. They were trying to be too clever, and it backfired. Now it's fourth down.
That timeout might be very useful for the offense. They're now ready to go. The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage.
They're changing things here. The quarterback changing. He's giving the receivers some new instructions.
Wright met after a gain of 8. That's his first reception today. They're going to the hurry up. Back to the line. They'll hike it to him out of the shotgun. Down the field. Leads us to second down. Play fake. Keeps it here. And it's swatted away.
Sometimes on third and long from the defensive side, I like the fact that you can blitz. Send more guys than they can block. Make the quarterback throw the football quickly and short. Then it's all up to coming up and making the tackle.
Play number 6 coming up on this drive.
You ready? Wait, four, four,
third and 10. C.O. Moore gets to the quarterback. Going for it on fourth down. The Vikings need to get to the 43 to pick up a first. Bridgewater's going to take it from the gun. And the pass is picked by Woodson. An open lane. Taking it all the way home for the touchdown.
Well, the quarterback, he could not see the defender. The defender in the right spot makes the catch and takes it back for a touchdown.
Add the extra point. The kick is good. The Vikings have been flat-out manhandled so far. Perhaps their special teams unit can change the momentum of this one. They need something to go their way. The score is 35-7. And a run back of about 15. The Vikings offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there, be aggressive, and see if you can score some points. Well, you're really in a tough spot, but that is a good job picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. All you can do, just keep picking up those first downs. You hope it leads you to a score, and then you play the game from there.
We return out of the two-minute warning. Fourth quarter action. First down at the 29. Out of the eye, it's Peterson. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
Well, even though they're getting blown out here late in the second half, they're going with the hurry-up offense. I like this. Just keep playing. Don't worry about the score.
Had it for just a second, but then it came out on contact.
Wallace has really hit hard that time. I know the football hit his hands, but when a defender times it perfectly like that, with that much power and speed going into that receiver, you are going to let that football go. That's human nature. Really good job by the defensive player.
Encroachment defense. Still third down.
Third down after the penalty. Here's the handoff to Adrian Peterson. Finally, a third down conversion.
When you're getting blown out like this in the second half, get in that hurry-up offense here at the end of the game. Get some practice in it, because I guarantee you, in the weeks coming up, you'll be in this situation, and you'll be glad you worked on your hurry-up offense.
Second down coming up. Toss to the outside. McGill's able to read that play and make the hit.
This is a good opportunity for this team to get some work in its hurry-up offense here late in the game. Even though they're getting blown out, go ahead and work on this hurry-up offense. Maybe next week you'll need it to win. The Vikings don't have a lot of options. A third and long situation. The pass goes incomplete, and the defense did a good job of staying back there and not giving up the deep throw.
They bring back out the offense to go for it. The Vikings will set up the 44, and he's intercepted. They bring him to the turf. That's got to be it. That's got to be the game ender here, partner. The interception basically ices it.
It does. You know, sometimes when you're behind as a quarterback, you take a chance, and that time the chance was just too great. Nice play by the defense.
A lot of things have to go wrong in any game for it to be this one-sided. But you look at the matchup at running back, and it's certainly just one more thing that stands out.
Yeah, when you run the football well, we all know you control the tempo of the game. And also, you get into all the situations that favor your offense and your defense. That's why they're blowing the other team out.
First down at the 43. It's wide open. breaks out of that one. He's up over 90 yards so far on the day.
This is an awesome job by the head coach, the offensive coordinator, and the offense. Just keep picking up those first downs. You got a big lead here in the second half. Keep that clock running.
First and 10. Takes it out of the eye. He's now averaging 6 yards a carry on the day.
Yeah, I love situations like this. This is when I was at my best, getting in the huddle and telling everybody all the things. Put two hands on the football. Don't anybody jump off sides. Don't take any chances. And most of all, stay in bounds. This is one good tackling defense. They stay in good position at all times. And we saw it that time, and they stopped the play for a short game.
Well, it's a...
Hey guys, thanks for watching our Madden 2016 tournament. We'll be back at GameStop on the 26th for our 2K qualifying rounds. This is Grease with Random Ethics. Random out. Hey guys, if you like that video, click here to see more and click here to subscribe.